Hello.
Your husband said to hunt you down Toronto. Alessandra sent me an email. Alessandra Nivolo, he said, hunt my wife down in Toronto. And I thought, is she here? What's going on?
You hunted me down.
And I did. That was, I was the one who left that message
I'm
on
so
your machine.
Pleased.
Okay, I am thrilled and honored.
No.
What a pleasure to meet you.
Thank you. It's such a pleasure to meet you.
And how
you
lucky
finally.
For Alessandra to have such a beautiful, talented wife.
You're so sweet.
You too. You two together. I can't stand it. It's a blinding flash of acting brilliance. And how great are you in this movie,
which
is named Harry
Brown.
Brown. That's it. That's it. So it's Brown means implies a serious film, and it is serious, even though I'm dressed in orange. But
Harry Orange wouldn't be such
a
serious.
I'm drinking
movie.
Orange juice, so we're very orange today. But anyway. Your movie, it was, you were wonderful.
Thank
you're
you.
You're such a wonderful, I'm
you're
just
so
overwhelmed
sweet.
To meet you. I'm just like,
and
anyway.
The movie's very good. And
yes,
and
it is.
Michael Caine is very good, don't
Michael
you think?
Michael Caine is incredible. I mean, it's one of his career-capping
performances.
Failed to maintain your women, son. I don't reckon you got long. I've seen that before. Gut wound. The slug's probably torn right through your liver. Mate of mine in Ulster got caught in sniper fire. Bullet blew his inside out. He screamed for a good 10 minutes. We couldn't send a medic in. The section was too hot. So we all took cover and watched him die. I've never told that to anyone.
I think
and
he
yours
might get,
too.
I think, I'm not sure about that, but I think he might get a nomination for
well,
it.
Well, let's get Michael another nomination for this part, which you want to, describe it for our viewers and your role in it?
He plays a vigilante pensioner on a sort of housing estate, a housing project in Britain.
Where I used to live, by the way. Anyway.
Where did you live?
I lived in Hackney. Michael and I bonded over this, and it was an old age pensioner block, but nothing like it.
Nothing like him.
Nothing like this movie.
You never met him.
No.
Were you a hoodie? Did you wear a hoodie and go around
with
a night?
No, it was more like I was in drag. I was wearing different kinds of hoods. That maybe a snood, but.
A fur snood.
Right. I was in my divine days back in the 70s before you were born. But anyway, so I lived in a housing estate in the East End, and so I knew this territory. But since it was an old age pensioner block of nothing but old age pensioners, then nothing violent happened like in this movie.
It's it's very violent.
And you play?
I play the detective, who's the kind of, I mean, if the model for this film, the director keeps saying the model for this film is a Western, really, which is this vigilante outlaw who's taken justice into his own hands in this kind of lawless neighborhood, lawless society.
I never want to live in London again.
That's what it's like.
Is that what it's like?
No, but it's a little bit. I mean, areas of it are not. It's not exactly like that, but very violent, lots of gangs, lots of meaningless killing.
Wow.
Anyway, I play the detective, or the sheriff character,
right.
And we're kind of two sides of the same coin, I guess, me and Michael. We're both very interested in justice and the idea of justice, but I believe in the law and that the law can be followed to the letter to protect the innocent, and he believes that the only way of protecting the innocent is to take the law into your own hands.
This was a game between Fisher and Spassky in Reykjavik in 1972. In the seventh match, Fisher opened with what's called a Pt.1 defence. He'd never used it before. Black concedes the centre of the board in expectations of a counterplay. Spassky was a rook tonight, Apple. When? Anyway, Fisher won.
You don't have anyone to play with.
No. Not since then.
You could always get one of those chess computer game things.
You didn't come here to talk about chess.
No. No, I didn't. I'm looking for some background information on Mr. Atwell. We recovered the murder weapon at the scene. It had Mr. Atwell's fingerprints on it, as well as fibers from his coat, suggesting that the knife belonged to him. To be precise, it was an old military bayonet. Mr. Atwell never served in the forces.
No.
You didn't give it to him, did you?
No.
But you knew he had it.
Oh, yeah, I knew. I think his dad gave it to him. He showed it to me.
When?
The day he died. Now, before you say another word, he was using it as protection. I mean, that man, he was frightened, terrified. These kids on the estate, they were harassing him. He came to me and asked me for help. I said, why don't you go and talk to the police?
Well, that was the right thing to do.
Oh, was it? He told me to talk to the police, and what did you lot do? Nothing.
Well, that may be true, but I have a problem. Counsel will argue that whoever killed Mr. Atwell did so out of self-defense, which means they'll be charged with manslaughter, not murder.
Jesus Christ. You came here to tell me that.
What lifts this film out of the realm of sort of just kind of a shoot-em-up, yes, is your beautiful performances, yours and Michael.
So thank heartfelt. Thank you.
And you really...
Because you're so nice, I want to just only be interviewed by you.
That's what Alessandra said. And I said, okay, I'll stop my career right here and just follow you around forever. Anyway, isn't he good? I mean, we shouldn't change the subject. Off.
He's wonderful.
In Coco Avant Chanel.
I haven't seen it. I'm seeing it on Tuesday.
Oh, my God. I know. We're up here, so we can't go down there.
Oh.
But he said he would fly back in and do a special. You can come too. In October after they fit.
Do you live here?
I live in New York.
Oh.
Right. So I used to
live in
London.
So we'll see lots of you in New York.
Oh, okay.
We're in New York. We're in Brooklyn.
I thought you lived in London.
No, we live in Brooklyn, New York.
Oh, okay. Okay. But you're both so... I mean, Alessandra gets so many hits, I just watch him every day on YouTube. You can watch us on YouTube and on the show.
You're going way back. And I know this award today is like... It feels like I should be about 80 years old or something.
No, stop it.
Anytime you start getting an achievement for your lifetime body of work, you start to feel old.
Well, when you turn 30, you'll know what it's like.
Shut up.
You're such a brilliant actress. You're known for... I mean, I wasn't ready quite for what... I didn't know what this film was about. No. And then because it's a serious, dramatic role for you.
You through the ringer, didn't
No,
we?
But it was a good ringer.
Because
it was so entertaining. And it's so... it engrosses you. It nails you in the first few minutes emotionally. And then you're like the sort of conscience of the movie
for
the viewers, I think.
Yes, and my conscience gets kind of battered by the end of the movie. That's what's interesting.
As well as you do, too.
And I do. I got black and blue by the end of this thing. It was very, very, actually quite hairy making it, because it was, it wasn't, there were no really not that, I mean, there were stunt people, but wherever possible, we were used. And thrown about.
Oh my goodness gracious.
I know, and sort of kicked around a bit. So I felt in fear of my life. I felt lucky to be alive at the end of every day on the shoot.
But it's wonderful how people, you sort of confound expectations, as does Michael, of course, every time he almost does something.
Oh, I know.
A great, great performance by Michael Caine in the name of the film again is
Harry Brown.